Jasmine Blues is Copacet, a real 1921 hotsy-totsy by the original Dixieland jazz band founded in New Orleans. Down in Louisiana, in the sunny climes, they play a classical music that is super fun. And it makes no difference if it was rain or shine, you can always hear the jazz music playing all the time. Music is integral to understanding this extraordinary age.
It is the first time music could be played whenever and wherever it was wanted. The first radio station is KDKA in Pittsburgh, and by 1924, Americans have bought 3 million radio sets. The gramophone is nifty.
Trouble is brewing. In 1920, the Congress passed the 18th Amendment, prohibiting the manufacture and transportation of all intoxicating liquors. Prohibition caused a problem. The problem was underground, in which was still available. People were taking the speakeasies and screaming from the police.
We're gonna get a wiggle on and get our LMS dancers out here. They're on the lamp, hiding from the police, looking for a spot to cuddle, black bottom, squirm, crank, snake hips, and Charleston.
Your talent is unbelievable.
undeniable. Now let's sit back, relax, and listen to the LMS Jazz Band as they play What Did I Do to Be So Black and Blue?
They targeted Mexicans, Asians, Jews, Catholics, African Americans, and any un-American groups.
Membership has grown to nearly 4 million members nationwide.
This new KKK has been known to participate in rallies, parades, and marches while burning crosses to intimidate their target.
We will keep you up to date as new information comes in about this terrifying turn of events. Let's welcome Mia Barnes to share a poem she wrote titled, "This Is What Harlem's All About."
Clash hats, happy faces, this is what Harlem's about. Loud singers, colorful paintings, this is what Harlem's about. Bob Terry, red lipstick, this is what Harlem's about. Black pride, equal rights, this is what Harlem's about. But in the shadows and in the darkness, bloody hands, bruised faces, this is what Harlem's about. Nooses, knives, this is what Harlem's about. But there's still hope, still beauty, this is what Harlem's about.
Pockets to get great products. By eliminating store clerks, as well as introducing bulk buying, we make sure that our stores are more economical.
I'm Sylvan Goldman, and you get to try out my revolutionary new invention, the shopping cart. Instead of needing to carry all of your items and drop some, you will get to use my nifty new invention that allows you to push a folding chair with wheels and a basket attached to it that you can put all of your items into.
It really is the cat's meow. It makes it able to shop economically, as well as without all those pesky issues.
The shopping cart, supermarket, and all these other great improvements hitting the stores everywhere. I'm so jazzed about the future of shopping.
Don't be rude. Come on down and spend your rube. Cha-ching.
Welcome back from that commercial break. That commercial sure was a rip snorter. Now we have Jamil Johnson here to read A Negro Speaks of Rivers by Harlem poet Langston Hughes.
I've known rivers. I've known rivers ancient as the world and older than the flow of human blood and human veins. My soul has grown deep like the rivers. I bathe in the Euphrates when dawns were young. I built my hut near the Congo and it lulled me to sleep. I looked upon the Nile and raised the pyramids above it. I heard the singing of the Mississippi when Abe Lincoln went down to New Orleans. And I've seen its muddy bosom turn all golden in the sunset. I've known rivers, ancient dusky rivers. My soul has grown deep like the rivers.